For all my new paramedic colleagues out there, there's one incident, there's one call that we all are looking forward to working and dreading at the same time, the core zero. Have you run a core zero? Have you run a cardiac arrest? Or have you been thinking about and preparing for, and most importantly, been very nervous about managing a cardiac arrest and being all on your own? This is one of the biggest calls that we can run. It's one of the most challenging, but it's also one of the most rewarding that we can be a part of. So let's talk about how we can improve upon our ability to perform better and manage those cardiac arrests like a pro. Let's discuss. Hey, welcome back to Hyper Academy. My name is Ryan Fields-Spack. It's a ruthless world out there. How do you stand up and step out? You do it by getting your mind right. That's what Academy is all about. We've got a very special episode for you today. Today we're talking all about how to perform better when you're a paramedic in the EMS field, specifically how we perform better managing cardiac arrests or a core zero. This is one of those big, significant emergencies that we all will eventually be called to. How do we perform better? And how do we manage those? And we're gonna talk a lot about that today. Specifically though, before we get started, I wanna give you a gift. I wanna give you something that will be tangible that you can take home as a result of our conversation today to directly and immediately improve upon your ability to perform both during a cardiac arrest or anything else you're doing in the EMS field. There's this concept called mindfulness, where you can bring your mind into the present moment and perform better. Specifically, there's a technique called First Just Breathe. It was brought about by Anne-Marie Rossi, and this technique can directly and massively improve your ability to perform in the moment. What I've done for you is built a one-page PDF guide that will run through the exact process for First Just Breathe. Once you read it, it should take no more than 3, 4, 5 minutes to read. You can implement this process and lower your blood pressure, lower your pulse, lower your anxiety immediately, so that you can perform better when something stressful is at hand. So this guide will walk you through the entire process. Once you've read it, 10 seconds, 3 steps, that's all it takes in order to bring your mind into focus on the present moment. The guide is available for you for free at hyperacademy.mykajabi.com/10seconds. I'll put a link down below in the description and you can go ahead and grab that there. Pick up the guide, might be beneficial to you specifically. So let's get into the cardiac arrest. When I was a paramedic with a very large metropolitan fire department, I was on a 4-person engine. So we were an all ALS department. So we had typically at least one medic on each engine. Sometimes we had 2, sometimes even 3, right? But it was one person that was in charge of a call. So typically if I was the medic on the engine and we got called to a cardiac arrest, it was my job to manage that incident and get everybody going. Now we had a huge benefit to this because we had 4 people on our engine. So I had 3 other people that I could have do some work for me. Plus we had another ambulance showing up with typically 2 other people, right? So manpower was not the issue, but that also brought with it challenges of how do I manage all of these people and keep us moving forward in a calm, poised, confident manner. That was the significant challenge that we faced as paramedics on our apparatus. You may be in a completely different situation. You may be in a rural area, or you may be on an ambulance and it's just you and your partner, right? So you're gonna have to work through some of these nuances that we've talked about here on this call to your specific situation, but I'll try to dial in some of that as well. So 3 things that you can do to improve upon your ability to perform during a cardiac arrest. The first thing that I really wanna talk about is getting your mind right. Before you even get that call, before you even start doing the actual tangible activity of running a core zero, you want to have your mind focused and right. So what I do every single day and what I did when I was a paramedic is I would meditate every single morning. Meditation is a fantastic tool to allow your mind to focus on the present moment when you need it. It's like doing exercise in the morning or in the afternoon. You exercise to make sure that you're fit to be able to do your job. You can exercise your mind to ensure that you're focusing on the task at hand. Meditation is very simple. I've got a lot of videos and I'll link one here in the description below that like button so that you can focus a little bit better on a meditation. But in a nutshell, meditation is all about staying in a place that's quiet, that's calm, if you can even give yourself 2 minutes, you set a timer and then you focus on your breath for 2 minutes. Inhale, exhale. The key to meditation is your mind will inevitably wander away from your focus on the breath. And that's where the benefit comes in. That's where the exercise, the rep comes. Noticing your mind wandering and then bringing it back to the present moment. And then noticing, bringing it back to your breath. Doing that meditation exercises your mind so that when you're running a cardiac arrest and your mind starts going this direction or the other, you will be able to notice that and bring it back in focus, right? Meditation will massively improve upon your ability to perform as you move forward. So that's the first thing that I would talk about, getting your mind right. The second component is to approach these challenging situations with confidence, with calmness, and with poise. If you allow your voice and your cadence and your pitch to go higher and faster, everybody around you that's looking to you as the leader of this incident and of this call will follow suit, and they will go higher pitched and less capable to perform because they are agitated right along with you, right? So that anxiety can be festered by the people around you. So if you approach things from a calm perspective, that is absolutely going to improve upon your ability to perform. So how do you do that? One way is to carry yourself with presence and improve upon your broad posture. Amy Cuddy talks a lot about this in her TED Talk, and you can look that up. I'll try to link the TED Talk below as well. How with a broad superhero type posture, your mind takes that posture and it will exude that confidence externally, and you will perform better by virtue of the fact that you are standing tall, that you are approaching that call, even driving to the incident itself with broad posture rather than a submissive posture. Your body and your mind will perform better with a higher caliber of presence. So carry yourself, and especially in the moment, with that broad, capable posture. The second thing that you can do is mentally rehearse the incident. More specifically, you can mentally rehearse it with your crew when you come on shift in the morning, right? So if you know you're going to get a cardiac arrest, and we'll talk about it in the third step, there are certain things that have to be done. And those can be things that you can rehearse ahead of time so that it's not something that you're trying to figure out in the moment, right? So if you mentally rehearse in your mind every step and every delegation you are going to give while you're on that incident, and view it in your mind and play it out and do the things that you did wrong over again, make the call in to the hospital in your mind and speak it out loud, those reps in your mind will help you perform better, right? So doing that mental rehearsal and then adding on top of it with the crew that you're with for the day, okay, if we get a cardiac arrest, these are the things that I want you to do. These are the things that I want this other person to do. That way everybody knows ahead of time, here's what's happening during a core, right? So good things there. And then finally, from the calm, confident, poised perspective, mindfulness. Being specific and lowering your blood pressure, utilizing that first just breathe guide that's in the link in the description to be able to lower your pulse, your anxiety, your nervousness. It immediately drops it from a physiological level. Practicing those tools when the call comes in, when you're driving to the scene, before you open the door, and before you walk into that house or that area where the cardiac arrest is, lowering your blood pressure by doing a mindfulness exercise each time will help you perform better and be less nervous as soon as you approach it, right? Presence, mental rehearsal, and mindfulness. Those are huge things to get yourself calm, confident, and poised. Now, let's get into the tactics, the third component of this. Once you get into that scene and you're getting ready to do the assessment and you're getting ready to treat this patient, there's a number of things that you're going to want to do. You've done your first just breathe exercise. You walk in there, and there are certain specific things that you're going to want to sign off no matter what, right? So the three things that you absolutely have to have is airway, right? So somebody needs to get on that airway. So you're going to want to sign that off, preferably a paramedic if you have it. If you don't, somebody, you know, depending on what types of airway control you're using, get somebody working on that airway immediately if possible. The second thing, obviously, once you confirm that this is a cardiac arrest, right? No pulse, no blood pressure, and no breathing, let's go ahead and get somebody started on compressions. So you got to get airway first, you got to get compressions next. The nice thing about airway and compressions, if you don't have a benefit of having multiple people that are professionals around you, you can assign those off pretty quickly. Do you have a fire department that's showing up after you've arrived and you're on the ambulance? You've already got airway established. Assign somebody to count every 10 seconds, every 7 seconds to give an air, to run that airway, right? It's a pretty easy thing to do. You can assign a firefighter. You can even assign a civilian if necessary to help you with compressions, right? You can coach them through the compression component throughout that process so you can free up more hands with your partner to do other things. The third thing that you need to do, of course, is make sure you get your monitor on, get it attached, and get everything going. Capnography, all of the different components with your monitor so that you're monitoring the patient and you've got the ability to defibrillate if necessary. So get that monitor on. In addition to that, of course, you have to have your IV placed if possible so you can give medications. And then you need to be able to have meds drawn up and given, right? So if you can get those three things going, airway, the circulation or the compressions, and getting those other components, the monitor, the IV, and the meds, I signed off and delegated, that allows you to do the most important part, which is standing back. What you don't want to allow yourself to do is to get task saturated. You don't want to get sucked into the minutia of starting an IV, of trying to get the airway going, of doing compressions, right? Because then you're not able to see the tactical component of what you're trying to do for this incident itself. You as the paramedic are in charge. So when you're standing about 6 feet back, you can manage the incident and delegate and see the things that others aren't seeing. Are there drug paraphernalia on the ground? What caused this? Can you talk with the family? Those kind of things. And while those compressions are going, now you can be the one that's running the monitor. That's what I typically did when I was running a cardiac arrest. I set the monitor aside. I was able to count down the timer and I would manage the time. Okay, we're coming up on our 60 seconds. Stop compressions. Let's check what the monitor has. If it's asystole, we're not going to do a shock. If it's a V-fib, if it's one of those that we can shock, let's go ahead and set that process up. Back to compressions. Let's charge the monitor. Okay, stop compressions. Everybody's clear. Shock, back at it. Right? And then you're managing. Okay, start with these meds. Let's give some epi, right? So by you standing back, you're at the monitor, you are managing the time, you're managing the components that are happening, and you're managing the treatment. Most importantly, you're managing it in a calm, confident, lower octave, steady state voice manner. That way, everybody else around you stays nice and calm. A cardiac arrest should be like riding a bike. Everybody around you should be nice and calm, and they should be managing the incident. No high voices, no anxiety. That's how a true professional runs a cardiac arrest, and it's very cool to see. And most importantly, it's very rewarding for you as a paramedic when you can run that cardiac arrest and do it really well. So, something to think about. I hope this was extremely helpful for you. Leave me some comments down below. How do you manage a cardiac arrest? How do you run these really big, scary incidents? From when you were a newbie to now as you are a veteran or a professional running these incidents. I'd be curious what your thoughts are too. To recap, you want to get your mind right. Do some meditations. You want to get calm, confident, and poised with presence, with mindfulness, with that mental rehearsal, and then get everything assigned out to your people and manage the tactics. Don't get task saturated. So, what else would you like to hear about from a paramedic perspective? We do these type of videos every single week. Would love to continue the discussion. If you like this type of content and you're in the EMS or the fire field, this is something that I absolutely love and will continue to produce content for Hyper Academy. Would love to hear what you'd like to hear and talk about. An absolute community. Hit the like button if you like this. Subscribe if you want to see more, and make sure to get your free guide down below, hyperacademy.mykajabi.com/10 seconds. Hope you have a great day. We'll talk to you soon. Thank you.